Hi, I'm Dr. J.V. Srinivas, Lead Senior Consultant, Department of Orthopedics at Aster RV Hospital, J.P. Nagar, Bangalore. Today is a very, very interesting topic I want to tell or speak out about this. Many people would have heard of avascular necrosis of femoral head or the hip joint. Basically, it means the blood circulation to the hip joint has come down or cut off, causing a lot of pain for the patients in the hip joint. Initially, usually these patients present to us with a diffuse pain in around the hip joint, not able to walk, or tiredness, not able to climb the stairs. These are vague symptoms, and most of the time these patients are not diagnosed of avascular necrosis because it's a rare phenomenon. But of late, this is more important because of this COVID pandemic. Of late, patients who have suffered with COVID, they have been given a high dose of steroids to recover from COVID and to recover from the lung symptoms what they had during the COVID pandemic. We have seen that drug-induced avascular necrosis, that is, a steroid-induced avascular necrosis, is very common nowadays after the COVID pandemic. As we all know, the COVID pandemic is evolving, and we know that we are not sure that we are in the peak of the curve or coming down or still we are ascending, and now we are talking about multiple waves in different countries. So we do have many patients who have recovered from COVID, but the after effects of COVID we are noticing now. There are multiple departments. It can be a pulmonology, like lung after effects are there, heart after effects are there, other metabolic condition. As far as bone and joint is concerned, patients who have been treated with COVID with high dose of steroids to make them recover from the lung symptom are developing avascular necrosis of both the hip joints. Of late, I have seen three of the doctors who have underwent a treatment for COVID had a high dose of steroids and landed up having a hip avascular necrosis. Now, hip avascular necrosis is a common phenomenon. Those people who take steroids is known to develop. This is called drug induced. Sometimes people take traditional medicines, like it can be Ayurveda, Siddha, or unknown medicines, high doses they take, they develop avascular necrosis. Or people suffering with sickle cell anemia, they can develop avascular necrosis. Or sometimes it is called idiopathic avascular necrosis, where we don't know the reason. But this was a small percentage of population suffering with this kind of avascular necrosis. COVID pandemic has made this condition more prominent nowadays. Now, patients who are coming with this avascular necrosis, if they are diagnosed early, that is, we have stage 1, 2, 3, 4. If they come in stage 1 and stage 2, we can salvage the hip joint or save his hip joint. In stage 3 and stage 4, if the patient is progressed, it's very unlikely we can save the natural hip joint and patient has to undergo a total hip replacement. And usually these kind of avascular necrosis patients are younger, especially males, and it may not be a good idea to a total hip replacement at that young age. But if worst come worst, we may have to do it. But if they can diagnose in stage 1 and in stage 2, nothing like that. We can save the natural hip joint. How do you try to save it? Now, we have certain medicines. There is no medical cure for avascular necrosis. Once the blood circulation is stopped, you need to immediately intervene and make sure the circulation re-establishes. So previously we used to do what we call core decompression. We used to do a large drill hole into the hip joint, allow the blood circulation to go inside. But this technique, patient needed or had to be on bed rest for 6 months. 6 months is a long period in nowadays. In the present world, nobody can be bedridden for 6 months. So what we are doing is a very unique technique called a core decompression with multiple drill holes. We take a small 3 mm drill hole, drill bit, and drill multiple drills into the femoral head, that is a hip joint, and allow the blood circulation to go inside. With this technique, patient can start walking on the next day. Maybe in 2 to 3 weeks, patient is completely back into normal daily activities, and the avascular necrosis process to recover or reverse will take few weeks. But definitely these multiple drill holes helps the patient to recover from the avascular necrosis. To further augment the recovery, what we are using is BMAC, bone marrow aspirate concentration. When we are doing a multiple drill holes, we take bone marrow from the patient's iliac crest, we concentrate it and we inject into the hip joint. It is having a high concentration of mesenchymal cells. These are cells which can transform itself into multiple cells, or you can call it as other way, stem cell. So when we take this and concentrate and inject, this mesenchymal cells goes inside the hip joint, transforms into a bone forming cell or osteocyte, what we call, and the new bone formation starts inside the avascular segment of the hip joint. We have started doing this BMAC injection after core decompression. Also, we have a technique called what we call stem cell injection, where we take harvest similarly like BMAC. We take blood from the iliac crest, we send it to the company, they culture it and give it to a stem cell concentration. We can inject the stem cell into the hip joint, and the recovery is much, much better than just only doing a core decompression. So today, what I want to suggest is, if somebody is having suffering with avascular necrosis, early stages, stage 0, stage 1, stage 2, they have to meet a good orthopedic surgeon as early as possible, plan their core decompression with multiple drill holes, and get your BMAC injection or stem cell injection to save your hip joint. Thank you. I hope this information was enough for you.